Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to Salem Youth Symphony's Spring Concert. I'm Cami Hetwer, Executive Director. Spring is a time of growth and renewal, and I'm so pleased to see all of you here today to celebrate the incredible journey our musicians have undertaken this year. I want to extend a warm thank you to our community of families, educators, and sponsors for their continuous support. Special recognition goes to John Harris Clippinger, our musical director, for his 25 years of service. You can find, you can read more about his journey in his welcome letter in your program. This year, we tried something new with fundraising, and thanks to your generosity, we've exceeded our expectations. Thank you, donors, our maestro-level sponsor, Uptown Music, and the businesses featured in our program. You can find links to our fundraiser on our website, and the QR codes posted around the venue. We are blessed with a large class of graduating seniors this year, and we'll miss them as they prepare to move on to new adventures. Visit our website to view a list of our seniors, their plans for the future, and their favorite SYS memory. In January, we held the annual Larry Garrett Youth Symphony Concerto Competition. We had an outstanding group of performers. Today, we are delighted to feature our concerto winner, Nicholas Peterson Hunt. You can read his bio and learn more about the competition in our program and on our website. Before we begin this concert, I kindly ask you to silence your devices and refrain from flash photography. If you need to exit or enter back in, please do so in between pieces. And now, I encourage you to take a moment to appreciate the impact of music, education, and community support on our young musicians. And now let's begin our concert with Mozart Players, conducted by Rachel Anderson.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
piece, we have a quick announcement to make. I'd like to introduce Joyce Epp. Joyce is the former executive director for Salem Youth Symphony and the heart and soul of SYS.
What a privilege it is for me to be able to honor, represent hundreds and even thousands in honoring John Harris Clippinger on this milestone event of 25 years. He's been a guiding force for Salem Youth Symphony Association this whole time and laid foundation for much of what you have heard tonight. 30 years ago, though, he was just a student here at Willamette. And now he's back on these hallowed grounds, and he's fulfilling a dream of being a music director for the Salem Youth Symphony and the director, conductor of the Advanced. But he's always had this excelled in a push for excellence, and he's been able to ignite inspiration, as you've been able to hear. So 30 years ago, while he was a student, I was living at the coast, and my own three girls needed an orchestra, a youth orchestra. So believe it or not, I drove weekly, you who complain, I drove weekly all the way from Newport to bring my girls to the Salem Youth Symphony Association experience. But at that time, I was introduced to John. It was 1999, and he got his first job with the Salem Youth Symphony as conductor of AMADEUS. And so from that, he moved on. He introduced the AMADEUS retreat, I believe, at that point. Then he moved his energies up to the PHILHARMONIA Orchestra. And that was supposed to be a full orchestra, but at that point, there were only about seven winds and brass in the whole orchestra, very small. And it was about that time also I moved in to Salem, and they asked me if I was crazy enough to drive, if I'd be crazy enough to be manager of the Youth Symphony. So that's when 2001 I started working with John, and I just saw that 15 years, that drive, the relentlessness, the sleepless nights of ideas, and of what it took to bring PhilHARMONIA, which you heard, and has so well been taken over by Danny, but John brought that up. And at that time, he also introduced the children's concert. And I think probably of any of you here, if you've been to Newport or Bend, some of your favorite memories are from those children's concerts. That was another one of John's visions. And at the time Larry Garrett retired, well, it was just really natural for John to step in and continue to use his unique, motivating, twist your arm, make the calls a dozen times, and bring his inspiration to developing the youth orchestra into what you hear today. And so no matter what the obstacles, and there are plenty, John has just pushed on. He believes so firmly in that every age, I've seen from the young to the old, the older youth, they should have that opportunity to develop their skills, and more than that, he has a way of helping them excel in expression and the emotion of it, and then finally to bring that gift, the excitement and satisfaction of you bringing the gift to the audiences as you hear today. And so you as today's audience are witness to this process that has been so dear to John's heart. Mm-hmm.